What's your biggest sexual regret? Dropped a girl off at her front door after a successful date. Said goodnight, kissed her, and said, "I've always wanted to do that." She responded, "Was there anything else you wanted to do?" "Nope. Good night." I drive away into the night, grinning like the stupid 19-year-old I was. It wasn't until a couple of years later I realized I'd missed an opportunity. Edit, Jesus. This is my top comment. The girl and I never hooked up. I ended up marrying her friend, but it didn't work out. The last 10 years I've been married to another wonderful lady, and we have a 6-year-old. I see my failure just about every day though, since we both have kids who are both in the same class. An ex-girlfriend invited another couple over to have a four-way. Except, it was a threesome, because I wasn't in town at the time. Hooking up with this guy. He starts going down on me, then comes up, and starts jackhammering, fingering me. He then looks at my vagina, while yelling like an army sergeant saying, "Get wet. Get. Wet." And I just looked at him with the most confused look while I slowly closed my legs, and get dressed, then just ran, and never spoke to him again. 16-year-old me, hooking up with my boss, and she brings up anal sex multiple times. My response? That sounds kinda gay. Edit. 16 is legal in my area. Most likely sleeping with other people without protection. Am now recently diagnosed HIV+. A girl I was sleeping with stayed over at my place. Her friend stayed too due to drinking. They slept in my bed and invited me in. I said I would sleep on the floor so they'd have room to sleep. I hate myself. Edit. It was two girls, and yeah, I think I pulled the gentlemanly move. Banging my friend's sister. We are still friends, best friends even, but his mom hates the out of me. Not screwing my bestie at the time, who was throwing major signals. I thought she was just a cuddler who for some odd reason wanted to spend the night in my bed, often. Girl on girl. A couple years back I discovered my girlfriend at the time was cheating on me. I confronted her, and we broke up, but it wrecked me. I was all over the place. She convinced me to go over one night, and I was so depressed I just wanted to get back to normal, and stupidly thought somehow we could get back together. Anyway, things escalated. Bad decisions were made, and we started having sex. The sex itself was pretty standard, considering the situation, until at one point, just as I was about to finish, I noticed several hiker/lover bites on her neck and shoulder that I hadn't given her. That one really hurt, and took a while to get over. And for anyone wondering, yes, I continued to her, and because it was fueled by anger, or whatever, it actually felt pretty great. Edit, whoa, this kind of blew up while I was away. Similar stuff seems to have happened to a lot of people. I'm a couple years later now, and things all worked out for everyone. I'm much happier with someone else, and she's still with the dude as far as I know. Cared that it happened, but at least it worked out, as I'm sure it will with the people that have been through similar stuff. I was madly in love with a friend of mine. She had always known I had feelings for her and vice versa. But I never tried anything, because either she was seeing someone or I was. Bad timing. Then it happened. I was single for a while and she just got out of a relationship. So we started hanging out. A lot. Then one day she asked if I wanted to stay the night. I was so happy to be able to sleep next to her. I wasn't going to try anything, because I wanted to respect her and not rush her into a relationship, but damn did I want to her. So that night, we are talking the whole night. About anything and everything. It gets late, and we are getting ready for bed. I had jeans and a t-shirt on, and she had a tight tank top on and booty shorts. So I crawl in bed and she says this, "Jeans aren't allowed in my bed." And I'm confused. If they weren't allowed, then I'd have to take my pants off. I tell her this, and she said she doesn't care. No jeans. So I take them off. And while I knew she liked me, I didn't think she wanted to me. And I just went to bed. The younger me, the you oblivious idiot. Edit, cheese and rice, this really blew up. Thank you everyone for the comments. It's good to know I'm not the only moron. I've hooked up with a lot of guys, a lot of times because I was really bad at saying no to people. It got to the point where, if I tried to decline, guys would pressure me, and I chose to just have sex with them, rather than stand my ground. I always felt like about myself after that happened. Edit. Wow. This was not the response I was expecting from Reddit. With the exception of a few, most have refrained from slut shaming. There's even a few who have confessed to slut shaming before, and didn't think about this part of a woman's perspective. So that makes me really happy. Thank you everyone for the kind words and support. Reddit really surprised me today. Haven't had sex in over a year. Met this fine and down to earth woman at the pub. Being drunk and totally punching above my weight, I asked her over for dinner and drinks. Fast forward to the next night, she is hotter and nicer than I'd remembered, 10 years younger than me too. And I'm terribly hungover. We chat, drinks, eat, chat. I'm feeling bad. Hot and cold waves, listening to her, but not focusing on anything but how bad my head and stomach are feeling. 4 hours later, she's sitting on the floor in front of me, stretching. She's a dancer, and asks if I'd ever had a lap dance. I tell her I'd had one at a club, but found it sleazy. I change the subject to something along the lines of feeling ill from the night before and maybe calling it a night. She makes a joke about me kicking her out already, then suggests I lay on the bed while she plays guitar. I thank her for the lovely gesture, but start cleaning up a little. I take her out to her car and that's that. I'm an idiot. Never had the nerve to call her again. That the girl I lost my virginity to doesn't know I was a virgin. I was embarrassed about it so I lied. Letting crazy stick their dick in me. Ended up with a pregnancy scare and an HIV scare all at once cause somebody neglected to tell me he was positive, and that he poked a hole in the rubber till after the big finish. Banging my ex's mom. Said mom was single, and had been drinking, and decided that this was her chance, to be really horny and seduce me. I had been drinking, and I needed absolutely no encouragement, to bang someone who looked like a clone of my then girlfriend, but with bigger tits. The sex was fine, and my ex never figured out. It's just weird that her mom still texts me when she's lonely. So for this story, it's important to know that as a high school kid I was ridiculously awkward and shy. Complete and total cringe level, but here goes. In high school, about 16 years old or so, had just finished an extracurricular contest with group, and we were eating out at Pizza Hut. Finished up and the teachers paid out. I opted to go get myself a refill of my drink before we left, and walked up, and asked the girl working at the counter, about the same age as me, for one. Her response, so, like, can I get your number? Me, I don't have a phone. Her, what about like, a house phone? Me, we don't have a phone at my house. Her, what about like, a friend's phone? Me, in full panic mode now, I don't have any friends. I ran out the door in a panic, didn't even take my drink refill from the counter. Turning down girls who threw themselves at me. I've always only been with women I loved, and now I'm single again, and want to have some fun, they are nowhere to be found. Last night when I tried anal with my girlfriend, did not go well. Tears aren't sexy, and neither is the sad kind of cuddling. The amounts of meaningless random sex. At the time I thought I was a student. Looking back on it though just makes me realize how depressed I was. Not going further with my roommate years ago. We got drunk and made out a couple of times. We are both girls and could have gone further, but I had my period. She started being hot and cold with me, so I kept myself in check around her. Even the night she summoned me into our bathroom after she had just had a bath and asked me to help shave her pussy. I did, blew the hairs off, and then walked out. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Cheating on my GF when I was 20. She never found out, broke up with her shortly after, and have now been with my wife for 9 years. Never even thought about cheating on her, but still feel bad about what a dick I was to that GF over some vag. My biggest regret is also one of my proudest moments. She was smoking hot, we clicked emotionally, had a few drinks at a party, kinda bumped into each other in the kitchen, started making out like teenagers. She suggested we sneak into a bedroom. I got some sense, mumbled some stupid excuse, and joined the bros at the BBQ. Her husband was in the next room and her kid was at home with the babysitter. The regret is that I really had more than lust for that woman. The pride is that I did not up her marriage. Someone else may have, but it was not me. Back when I was about 16, I went over to this girl I was talking to's house late at night and snuck in, and spent the night. Now, being that I was a private school raised, sheltered young man, I didn't have the social maturity to know that, if a girl invites you to spend the night and sneak in her house, then you should probably just go ahead, and stick your hand down her pants. Needless to say, I did not. I snuck out at about 5 a.m. before her mom got up for work, and walked 6 miles back home down a busy freeway. Definitely my nastiest case of blue balls, and one of my biggest regrets. I had a very close female friend for about 3 years I was desperately in love with. She never outright returned my feelings, but we had many encounters of the budding adolescent variety that I hoped one day would end up with PNV. One night she fights with her mother and comes over to my house. She asks if she can stay over. Not a problem, I say. She insists we sleep in the same bed. When getting ready for bed, she strikes up a conversation about how she usually sleeps topless and asks if I'd mind. Of course not, I say. What could be more natural between two good friends? During the course of going to sleep, she makes herself into a small spoon and slides my hand up over her left breast and lies there. I assume this is part of what normal friends would do, and ignoring my own comfort, I fall asleep. We wake the next morning to her mother banging on the door, and she is dragged home. Our night together forgotten. Another time with the same girl and a very attractive friend of hers. We are about 17, and sharing a bottle of cheap vodka someone stole from somewhere, and the two of them begin to make out and teasingly try to get me to join in. They compare breast sizes in front of me, and make jokey comments about how being a room like this must have me hard as a rock. I defended myself, wanting to be cool. It takes way more than this to get me going. And I sat at that table in that completely parent-free caravan at the back of the yard, sipping vodka and watching them trying to entice me, resisting their charms like a boss. Went on a date with a girl. She asked what I thought about sex. Cue awkward silence. We go back to her place and chill for like 3 hours, but don't have sex. Looking back, I had it in the bag, then didn't know what to do. I still see her around all the time, but she friend-zoned me because I was too big a puss to close the deal that night. Edit, I was being sarcastic about the revenge king. I'm happily in a relationship, and the girl and I are good friends to this day. Live and learn. I ended up going on a date from a girl from /r/gone wild once. I had a different account back then. She was really hot with huge tits, not chubby but not thin, and she loved going down on me almost as much as she loved me going down on her. She was perfectly shaved, and the experience was delightful. I ended up not texting her back quickly enough, and she found another guy within like a day and they are dating now. Now I don't get nudes from her, and she doesn't post on Gone Wild anymore either. When I was in high school, I lost my virginity to a guy that was attractive, charming, funny, and refused to touch me after we had sex. He would be so sweet and into me before the act, and then immediately after, it was like a switch would turn off. After he came, he would turn over, look at the clock, and ask me when I'm leaving. It left me feeling so unwanted and unattractive, but in a sick way it made me try that much harder to keep his attention. I learned how to negotiate cuddle time with him, and he would time it. I could get 10 extra minutes in bed with him if I was lucky. He convinced me that all guys were like this, and if they weren't, they were probably gay. This was only one of many manipulative behaviors he had, and it left a big dent in my self-esteem. We continued to have a 5-year relationship that consumed the best parts of my teen and college years. I was so naive, and I spent way too much of my time picking myself apart because of him. The first time I had sex with a new partner, and they held me after, I burst into tears, because I thought they were just being nice at first. Turns out men really want intimacy too.